Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Board Destruction. Today we have an iPhone 6S. This thing is honestly still in pretty good condition considering its age, but this thing is water damaged. I got given this thing by the YouTuber ADAO8. From what I remember, this thing took a swim in a toilet. Before this was sent out over to the UK, this thing used to turn on, but ever since then, it doesn't even turn on anymore. Not like any of that matters now. Let's get into this episode of Board Destruction, iPhone 6S. In the destruction of the iPhone 6S, we're going to be doing a very quick drop test. The back's made of aluminium, so it should be fine, but let's get into it. Back drop, waist height, 3, 2, 1. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. The camera broke. For all the time that I praised the durability of these things, I never expected the camera to break in such an easy drop. But the camera is now cracked. So if your iPhone 6S took the same fall, you would not be taking pictures anymore. Corner side, chest height. And now, the face down drop, waist height, 3, 2, 1. I am shocked. This iPhone 6S took that face drop surprisingly well, so it's going for another round. 3, 2, 1. Since after that drop test, it only got this one little hairline crack, I have one more drop test for it, and I only did this to the Samsung Galaxy Ace. So this will be the second device to really do this drop test. So of course what we're going to do is just push go. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. So this is the iPhone 6S after taking two falls from my window, I think. The bottom or the back half, this thing like randomly disconnected and the Touch ID cable is completely ripped. As for the display, it doesn't look so good. The entire display is completely shattered. And yeah, we have that ripped cable. Other than that, this thing needs a third throw. 3, 2. So then, the iPhone 6S after three drops out of my window. As you can tell, the whole screen is completely cracked. The Touch ID sensor is shifted. There is quite a lot of glass missing towards the bottom. That happened on the third and final drop. And if we look on the back, things don't look too much changed. But then if you look on the bottom, you can see the screen is trying to push out. There is a dent, which looks a lot like how my 6S Plus used to look before I repaired over the shell. And there is a massive gap right here, and I can peel up this antenna line. While there may not be much point, I'm bored, so yeet! Screen doesn't even look too much worse considering this is a ludicrous drop test. When the iPhone 6S launched, Apple made a big deal over the 7000 series aluminum. And so I want to kind of push the limits of this a little bit. Even though it was a shit idea because of the paint starting to do this. Which sure, it happened on the iPhone 6, but it wasn't as bad. And so will it pull an iPhone 6? Let's find out. One more time. So there's one dent right here and the loudspeaker came out. And as you can tell, there's just more shit wrong with it. And this thing's bent. Other than that though, it really doesn't look too bad. Also, yeah, the battery's removed, but other than that. What about the slab? To be honest, I wish this phone worked, but oh well. 3, 2, 1. Got my nice one grit. 3, 2, 1.
7000 series aluminum, everyone.
I don't really know what I'm doing, if I'm honest, but it's fun. Baby hammer. Oh my. Baseball bat on the camera. Probably a bit late for this, but water test. More water.
Take the water and enjoy it.
Man, it's getting dark and it's dripping wet. What am I gonna do? Yeah, alright, I give up. I'm kind of running out of ideas, as you can probably tell. But here, I have an LG Optimus L3. And I'm going to launch the camera, and I am going to throw this LG Optimus at that iPhone 6S. Oh, fuck off, LG. Oh my god, the government's going to steal our fingerprint. Yeah, so this is all the sensor fucking is. The glass just makes it look nice. And now it's starting to get late and dark, so iPhone 6S, I'm coming back for you tomorrow. Alright, so the bottom half of that screen, not quite cracked enough, so... Camera lens? I'd completely missed. What if this iPhone 6S is secretly a fish? We should find that out. Will it bend though? It is ever so slightly bent. Nope, I give up. Day 3 with filming this video, even though I've been filming this for the past month now. Right before we get to the baseball bat, here is the machined Apple logo. Alright, at this point we might as well just put them out of their misery. But first, before we do that, before we get on with the 6S, we have unfinished business. And now with the past out of the way, let's get back onto the present. That iPhone got destroyed, but hey, at least it was a fun callback to what I used to do to iPhone 5s a long time ago. Plus, an iPhone 6 series on board destruction was something that I always wanted to do, so I finally got to do it. I would like to shout out 8808 for donating me the iPhone and Delta for helping edit this video. Also, sorry I didn't burn the phone. I didn't have time to. I wanted to get a video out before I start college, so this is pretty much my only chance of getting a video out. And so on that note, thank you guys all so much for watching. Comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye!